welcome. This is new and old. Today I wanted to do a video or start of a video on this Lincoln Town Car. Now, let's go over this car a little bit for viewers that don't already know. I bought this Lincoln Town Car pretty much, I drove up to, it was at the Coast Range here in the Pacific Northwest. The guy was kind of touchy. I mean, it wasn't the world's greatest. Ended up paying $1,100 for it. Got him to knock off $100. Got it home, and it immediately needed some work. Let me show you. Let me just show you what I've done so far. When I got the car, the car was in horrible condition. The interior was stained. It had little bits of mold on it. The car, it really was. Once I got it home, I found out, I shouldn't have paid what I paid for it. To me, this car was a $600 car. But title was already signed. All well. So basically, I decided, let's see what we can do. So I went through it, took it down to my mechanic, and we immediately found an issue. If I can get this open. Immediately found an issue. Someone, in all their wisdom, broke the idle air control, or not the idler, broke the idler pulley. Straight off. And instead of fixing it the correct way, they JB welded it and took it off. So the belt was running off of, basically it was running off the tensioner, and right around there, it was rubbing. So, and long story short, the whole entire front of the motor had to come apart. And basically, we had to replace everything in the front. Didn't do the water pump, didn't do things like that, but had to be done. $1,300 later. Then in the midst of that $1,300, they also punctured the radiator. The radiator was basically trashed. They punctured it. I don't know how they did it, but so we had to fix that. When I got it back, and I had to, this Mickey Mouse setup here, I don't know why someone would do something like this, but I guess it's sir. But basically, I had to go back and redo it and, kind of make it. Yeah, I need to get another box, an actual air box. If I can find one of these cars, a decent one at the junkyard, I very well may. But for right now, this works. But I immediately found out in the Department of Maintenance this car was lacking. Ran great. I mean, this car runs extremely well. It's got low mileage, but it's lacking in the maintenance department. I went to go change the spark plug. The spark plug wires on this broke. Basically, they were original on this car, and they just plain old wore out after 20 years of use. So, change that. Spark plugs, they had auto lights in some, and then the original Motorcraft in others. Okay, so long story short, I did that, fixed it. Now the car is running good, everything's working. So I decided to do an experiment. Now this car's got 147,000 miles on it, so the trans has probably never been touched, as far as I know. We can see here, I will put my camera down right here. I can do it, and I will show you guys the transmission fluid. We'll pull it out. Now, it isn't running, mind you. It isn't running. But all we want to know is the color. The color of the transmission fluid and the smell of the transmission fluid. Now, this is, does not need transmission fluid. It is completely full on the trans fluid. And there's no leaks underneath this motor, which is kind of amazing, to be honest. Make sure that's on there good. Yeah. So I'll take it out again. I'll show you guys. We'll put some on here. Now, Ford recommends the trans service be done every 60,000 miles, a full trans service. At least that's what they recommend on this particular transmission. Now, if I see, that's what the transmission looks like. It's got pink to it still, but you can tell it's getting wore. It's wore. 147,000 miles. It's probably never been done. So, but it doesn't look tremendously burnt. I mean, it's got a little bit of a burnt to it, but it's wore. So I decided, let's do an experiment on this. We're going to take it for a quick test drive. We'll make sure this is full. Now, granted, the transmission is full, for the most part, this trans chips okay. It does have, it's a little rough, but it ain't bad. So we're gonna take it for a quick test drive here, and I'm gonna show you guys a before and after on the trans service. Again, runs fine, no problems. If you can see, the mileage is at 147,150. So it's kind of low mileage for a Lincoln Town Car, really. So, let me get my seatbelt on here. And you know the law, we gotta be legal. Okay. So it goes into reverse just fine. Nothing wrong. Instantly into drive. We'll take it around the block here. And you guys can see, I'm sorry for the shaky camera, I gotta be careful here. It's got a little bit of a whine to it. But not too bad. Not too bad. We'll continue here. Just go around the block. That's all we're gonna do. And listen. Shifts fine. I mean, there's no problem with the shifts at all. We're probably in second. That's third. And then when we get up to 40, it'll go into four. So we'll go down a long stretch here, if I can get my hand out of the way. We'll go down a long stretch here. So it's probably in second. This might be in third. There, now it's an overdrive. So it shifts fine. Nothing wrong with the transmission as of yet. Now, my experiment is, since this car is not worth anything, it's really not worth very much at all, you know, $1,000, if that. I have way too much money into it as we speak. But I'm going to do a little experiment. I'm going to take it in for a full flush, a full trans service and flush. And we're going to see what happens with this car. Will the transmission die? Or will it shift even better? You know, that's the key. I mean, well, and that's what I'm curious too, because I know this has not had the greatest luck of them all. I know this car has been neglected in the maintenance department. But the trans does not look that bad. I mean, it doesn't look like it's that burnt. Now, if it was super burnt, I would say this car is not going to survive flat past the flush. But as you can see, it runs great. It shifts fine. It shifts smooth. We'll just go around here. We'll go up a little hill. I mean, it's fine. Now, could I be opening up a can of worms? Of course I could be. I could be opening up a lot of can of worms by doing this. Or I could be making this transmission last another 200,000 miles. I don't know. You know, I honestly do not know. But to be honest, at this point, I've stuck so much money into this car to keep it going. I think doing this experiment, I'm curious. I'm curious to see what this experiment will do. So, anyways, I'm going to go ahead and let you guys go. We don't want to get this video too long, but this will be the experiment. This will be part one. And then part two, I will take it down and I'll stick the camera in when I first drive off and see what happens, see what I feel. It'll be an interesting experiment. It definitely will. Anyways, this is New and Old. Thank you for watching. Like, subscribe, leave a comment if you shall do wish. And we'll see you for part two, the service.